Hi, this is Yasir from WPHowKnow, and in this video we will see what is a subdomain, how it works, and how to create a subdomain in cPanel. But before starting, please subscribe to our YouTube channel so that you keep getting our content regularly. Basically, a subdomain is a part or section of your main domain, and mostly it is used to organize or divide your web content into different sections. Let's understand it with an example. Suppose your website is a building and ground floor is its main entrance point. And this floor contains all the important data of your website like posts, pages and landing pages, etc. After some time, you decide to have support, forum and gallery sections for your website. And for that, you dedicate one floor to each department. Now, each new department will act as a subpart, or we can say that a subdomain for your website. Now, before going any further, let's take a look at the components of a domain name. Suppose your website domain name is www.abc.com. In this domain name, the .com part is known as top level domain or domain extension. And ABC part in this domain name is called second level domain, which is also the identity for your website. And you know what www part is? Actually, it is a subdomain. Most of the web hostings create this subdomain for you automatically. Although subdomain is a part of your main domain, but it is completely different entity. On a subdomain, you can use any platform or CMS irrespective of what is installed on your main domain. For example, if on your main domain WordPress is installed but you want to use Drupal, Joomla or PrestaShop on your subdomain, then you can do that easily without any problems. And since a subdomain is a completely different entity from the main domain, so it will have its own sitemap, indexing and SEO related stuff. On a main domain, you can install as many subdomains as you want. Now let's see how to create a subdomain using cPanel. First, log in into your cPanel account, and once you are in the cPanel, search for the domain section and under it click on subdomains. Under the subdomain label here, it is asking you to write your subdomain name. You can write any name you want. We will go with the name help for our new subdomain. Next, you have to select the domain to which you want to attach your subdomain. If you have multiple domains attached to your web hosting account, you will see all the domains in the drop-down list here. We will attach our subdomain to wphowknow.com. So we will select it from here. In the next step, it is showing the path where all the files related to subdomain will reside in future. You can change it if you want, but for now we will go with the default path. After this, click on create button. Now it will take some time to create folder and update DNS entries for the new subdomain. Once the subdomain has been created successfully, you will see a message here. Now the question is, what is the address of your newly created subdomain and how you can access it? Simply replace www part in the domain name with the name of your new subdomain, which means we can access our newly created subdomain with the name help.wphownow.com. To see our newly created subdomain, once again let's go to the subdomains page. For that, click on go back button here. Here you can see the newly created subdomain, and this will be the path for the subdomain files. If you click on this path, it will take you to the file manager, and files related to your subdomains can be found here. For now, it is almost empty because we haven't installed anything on the subdomain yet. In one of the upcoming videos, we will show you how you can install WordPress on a subdomain, and if you don't want to miss that, please subscribe to our YouTube channel now. And that's all for this video, in which we have learned what is a subdomain, how it works, and how can you create a new subdomain in cPanel. If you like this video, please hit the like button and share this video. Thanks for watching.